Respected ambassadors, dear ladies and gentlemen, god morgon, hyvää huomenta, and dobre udra. Ksasalenio ja niekavario paruski. I've got a chancelling subject. What we are doing now, we are trying to build an European Arctic Sea Railroad. And because we do not have oil and gas, we have to carry them, transport them. What is the background? As you know, the Finnish origin, Professor Nordenskjöld was the first person who sailed through Northeast Passage, and now we are back again for utilizing it. You all know that ice extent is lowering. Last September it was 4.4 million square kilometers, lower than this scale. Also the thickness of the ice is decreasing. Summer ice is already under 1 meter, and winter ice is under 2 meters. And what best it is now 1 year ice, which can be broken easily than older ice. This was the situation in September 2010, when this ship was carrying iron ore or iron concentration from Kirkenes to Shanghai. So it's open, the sea is open. And my personal opinion is that we cannot do anything for climate change is going on. We cannot do anything to stop it. So think the icebergs, where to put them later. What is the vision, our vision? It is a new global trade road between Europe and Asia. So the map tells very clearly how short is the way from Asia to Europe or from Europe to Asia. Tsudi Shipping, which you here in Kirkenes very well know because it owns the part of the harbor, also the mine, has compared the competitive edge of this North Sea road to the road through Suez canals. If you start your journey from Kirkenes, go through Suez Canal to Shanghai, it takes 39 days. And if you go through Polar Road, it takes only 21 days. What does it mean? 18 days save in time, nearly 50% less pollution, $800,000 saving per ship, per one trip. It means $20 per one ton to carry goods from Kirkenes to Shanghai. If you have a 20 feet, 20 TEU container, it means, and if it is fully loaded, 28 tons, it means 560 euro saving. It's a lot. So this is a profitable road, and we have to help it during winter time even to open it. Why we are building this new global trade road? Perhaps this map shows clearly. Finland belongs to a former Russian Empire railway system. We have 1,524 millimeter Kauk. Russia has got 1,520 millimeter Kauk railroads. Why there is a 4 millimeter difference? It is because we had 5 feet system, the old one. But when Stalin and his comrades, his friends were looking, why we have got that 4 millimeters? Let's take it off, let's standardize the railroads. That's why the difference. But in practice, it doesn't matter. But any case, through Kirkenes, for example, we can get direct access to second biggest railroad system in the world. I have here circulated by red triangle, red line, the countries we can reach by this railroad system. So there are the Russian-style railroad system and the neighboring countries. Huge area, huge custom potential, huge industrial area. There are several options to build the railroad, and recently Finnish Ministry of Transportation and Communication had set up a work group to evaluate these railroad lines. I have done it already for the Finnish National Emergency Supply Agency, and if I can say here the secret, it is the Kirkenes line which seems to be the best. Why? Why? It is because at the same time when we are building the Kirkenes line, we are building the industrial Lapland. It serves at least three new mines in Sodankylä, and also Sokli, I think, could utilize this line. I recently visited Canada, and they are seriously building or developing airships, for example. This could be connected to railroad system. Unmanned airships can bring ore from the mine to the railroad line. This is I don't confuse you about this idea, and because you don't believe me later about the whole idea if I tell it more, but you will hear about it. So this is the idea which Arve Tannevik has pushed a lot, also Odger Danielsen, who is now working in Helsinki for promoting the logistic connection in Nordic area. Esko Lotvonen has made a lot, and also Timo Lohi, whom you know very well here in Kirkenes. So there are also other options, and Skipotten was a very serious one, but after Nordic Resources decided to bring their iron ore through Narvik port, it lost its economic backbone in a way. So I'm so sorry for Anne Praten, who has worked a lot for that. Hopefully we can sometimes merge our efforts anyway. Let's go back to this in this case, that what is missing link here? It is the railroad connection, this Arctic Sea Railroad, and that's why it has to be built. Another other missing link is how to get over the Gulf of Finland. There is a regional land and transport planning going on in Finland, and for example, town of Hanko has already proposed that they can build a rail ship harbor for this line. And also town of Kotka is interested. On the long run, I think it's important to build up a rail ship harbor also in Helsinki, because Helsinki is dreaming about a tunnel under the Gulf of Finland, and it is not economically viable, but it can be in some in the future. If you think, for example, bridge from Sweden to Denmark, it wasn't possible without rail ships, ferries, and so on. We have to grow up the traffic. Why Finland? Why we need? If I tell our point of view, why we need this sea corridor and new railroad connection. It is because of Lapland's transportation needs. We need it for mines and minerals transportation, wood, we have to bring food for pulp and paper industry and also for energy production. As you know, we are planning to start a rather heavy biofuel industry in Finland. Then tourism, but these are only needs of Laplands. This is also way how we can really have some economic, really serious economic cooperation with Norway, with northern Finland and northern Norway. So in the regional economic development. And then we can also take part in Arctic oil and gas industry development. Supply equipment and all kind of maintenance services. We can import oil and LNG from Norway. And perhaps even more important is the needs of our heavy industry transportations. We have got, as you know, comparably strong base metal factories, pulp and paper industry, chemical industry. So they are transport intensive industries. And we want to build up an export way to the fastest growing markets, which are in China and in Asia generally. We also have got a strong mechanical engineering and machinery industry, which has got subsidiaries and daughter companies in China, especially. So there is a lot of subcontracting works and a lot of sub-parts has to be bring from Asia to Europe, from Europe to Asia. And then this also means a cheap and faster road for import from Asia. And we can also make business by transit transport to Russia and other Commonwealth independent states. There are also possibilities to build up new global seaborne businesses for Arctic shipping companies. We have got an idea to sell, for example, our three icebreakers, which are mainly working nowadays for Canadians, and one is working in Mediterranean, and use that money for making new icebreakers for Gulf of Botnia and Gulf of Finland, which can be used for environmental protection also. But there is three icebreakers. If you want to buy, contact me. So there is a possibility also to build up a European railroad operator, really international railroad operator. I hope our state railways understand this. But if not, then we have got open markets for competitors too. And of course, what is very important is Arctic maritime engineering and shipbuilding, which is strong in Finland and partly owned by Norwegians. We need railway vehicles and related technologies, IT services, and so on. And of course, the very important reason for this new railroad is supply security of Finland during crises and wars. As you know, we are there, and if you close 90% of our exports goes through Baltic Sea, 70% of our imports comes from through Baltic Sea. So if somebody close the Danish that waters between Sweden and Denmark, how can we survive? Then this will help us to survive. Okay, there are some import-export figures from Finland, Baltic States, Poland, Czech, Slovakia, between China, Japan, South Korea, and Hong Kong. They are our trade with those countries are around 10 million tons nowadays. And half of export from these countries, now you can learn Finnish, comes from Finland. So we are heavy exporter to Asia. Half of imports from Asia in tons goes to Poland. There is transit traffic via Finland to Russia and from Russia. It's around 8 million tons. A lot of these tons can go, for example, through Kirkenes. So there is a business potential, and when the railroad has been built, it will create a new traffic and new businesses. There's a ready-made line in Baltic states already. There are operators who can carry further our goods to Vienna, Milano, and so on. So let's have a joint political agenda to promote this connection. Finland and Norway together has to introduce this idea to the European Union and has to make they will really realize that this could be the northern and Arctic somehow channel to Asia, more profitable than they now have. International Maritime Organization have to make a maritime, not roles, but rules for Arctic sailing. It means that we have to prepare this polar code. Then practical matters, land and transport planning has to take into account, and financing. We have planned with Odger that we will go to China's investment corporation and discuss with them about this, and also with Japan investment companies. Anglo-American, who will build a big mine in Sodankylä, is also used to finance this kind of investments. So, and what is most important, perhaps, we have to build up a joint program and financing for boosting synergic investment here in Nordic regions. We have got metals, you have got energy, why don't merge them? So perhaps this is future of Kirkenes. Thanks.